That's Karen Nelson, 5'4 junior out of Laurel, Maryland. Her career best on the vault, a 9.9.
UCLA is making a strong comeback. They finished ninth place at Nationals last year. They really want to improve that standing. Another handsome shot of the half, but a much better landing. I'm sure you can notice how the camera is shaking. If you could stand on this floor, it's spring-loaded, and it's really rocking the cameras. I remember when I was standing out there, I couldn't believe how much movement there was. Nice position. And of course, a much better landing. Vault will score definitely higher.
Terrific free flight.
The judges look for good, clean form, legs together, tight, tough position, and the all-important landing.
Karen Nelson huddles with her Lady Bruins while they await her score. As we near the end of the first rotation, we're coming back to Maples Pavilion. We'll have Karen Nelson's score as the Pac-10 Women's Gymnastic Championships continue. Along with Kathy Johnson, I'm Phil Stone. We welcome you back to Stanford University. We are at Maples Pavilion for the Women's Pac-10 Gymnastics Championship. A moment ago, we watched this young lady, UCLA's Karen Nelson, the final vaultist, her score, a 9.8. We are set now for rotation number two. Washington will move to the vault, UCLA to the bars. Arizona State has a bye, as does California and Stanford. Arizona is on the beam and the floor exercise. This time around, we'll go to the Beavers of Oregon State. Here is Amy Thorne.
Now keep in mind, in team competition, there are six gymnasts competing, but they can drop one low score. And right now, UCLA has a 9.1 that they would like to drop. Because they have two very strong scores, a 9.7 and a 9.775. And if they can drop that 9.1 and build to even higher scores with their remaining three gymnasts, they will secure a very, very strong position in the team competition.
What we are about to see, Kathy, from Amy Thorne is a big swinger on the bar. She likes to grab hold and really cut loose, a la a Kim Hamilton, in that she loves to bring the crowd into her performance.
She has a huge release move, and unfortunately, she was having trouble with it in warm-up, so it'll be interesting to see how she handles it here. I know she's a little bit nervous. In fact, she walked by me during the warm-ups and said, I'm having a little confidence problem here. But she has a lot of experience. She's a senior, competed for many, many years, so I'm sure she'll handle it. The judges look for the big, giant swing. This event has changed a lot over the past few years. The bars now go out a lot farther and enable the gymnasts to really swing bigger and do bigger release moves. So she's coming out right here. That's what she was having trouble with. And it was, oh, no. The skill down to the low bar is what she had trouble with. Her feet brushed the floor. That will be a deduction. Amy has two release moves in her routine, which makes it much stronger than many of the other gymnasts. And a double twisting flyaway. Much more difficult a routine than we've seen so far.
The one problem on the low bar will certainly cost Amy Thorne dearly.
That is just gorgeous, way up in the air. But as she swung through the bottom here, she hits the ground. This is beautiful. Double twisting flyaway. You seldom see this in competition. She does it beautifully.
The senior from Huntington Beach, California, her coach Scott Bull was telling me earlier tonight that she's really our team clown. She's light, she's airy, but boy, when it comes time to approach the apparatus, tremendous focus. And her score, a 9.8 for Amy Thorne. And here comes her teammate, a sophomore from Meriden, Connecticut, Karima Mero. And I think she is certainly one of the heavy favorites in the all-around in this competition.
She really is a very good all-around gymnast. She doesn't have a weak event. Her strongest event, the vault and floor exercise, but she's also very aggressive on this event. Look how strong she swings. And really goes for the handstand position. Here comes her release move. Reverse hack. Dismount. A pike double back. Now, we've seen several tuck double back flyaways. She does it with straight legs in a pike position, makes it much more difficult. This is her reverse hex. Watch, it's a blind move. She flies backwards over the bar and makes the regress well above the bar, something the judges look for. And the dismount. Watch how her legs stay straight. She gets into a nice pike position. Takes a step on the landing. Of course, that will be the deduction in the routine.
A tremendous talent, Karima Mero, just a sophomore from Meriden, Connecticut. Just a few weeks ago at Pauley Pavilion in Westwood, California, at the UCLA Invitational, she won the all-around in leading UCLA to an upset win over Arizona State and four other teams at Pauley. We'll return to Maples Pavilion in Stanford with more of this Pac-10 championship in a moment. Welcome back to Maples Pavilion. The second rotation still underway. This is Arizona's Stacy Fultz as she gets set to mount the balance beam.
And this is one of our all-around favorites, as we mentioned. Arizona has been competing quite well in this event. They have one low score of 8.75. But if Stacy in the final gymnast can hit, they can drop that score. Beautifully executed layout. As we mentioned, Arizona has been hindered by two major injuries. Two of their top gymnasts, Anna Basildua, who was the national champion on the vault last year, and also senior Jamie Jones, out with reconstructive knees.
Stacy coming off a terrific junior year, which she captured All-America honors on the beam, the bars, and the all-around.
Very difficult turn. A double turn, and then she puts her foot down and executes another half turn. Very risky. Dismount. Cartwheel to a swing through and a full twist. This has become a very common dismount in collegiate gymnastics. Very nice job. Christy Gunning, by the way, scored a 9.7. She went up third. Here's her double turn. Watch how she has to spot the end of the balance beam, places her foot down, and then does another half-turn pivot. She loses her balance just slightly, so that'll be a small deduction. Here's that dismount. Now watch, she takes off of one foot. She swings the other one through into the full twist. I think we're going to have a very interesting all-around competition here.
Well, it's beginning to take shape. There is the senior from Mesa, Arizona, Stacy Fultz, as she awaits her score on the beam. There's what I spoke of just a moment ago, an All-America in three events in 1992.